That was The Residents with main titles God and Three Persons off of their 1988 album God and Three Persons. The Residents are an insane group. They've been around since 1969, and I don't even know how many albums they've had. I mean, if you look at studio albums, it's a pretty long list. There are like three layers of lists on Wikipedia.com. And then there's a ton of other shit. It's hard to listen to all the Residents, but when you dip in once in a while and grab something out of the Residents, you find something really good. And I've never really listened to very much 80s Residents. I did have this Residents compilation that had some 80s stuff in it, but I think my favorite so far has been Duckstab. They're a weird group that I think nobody really knows who they are still. Huh. Apparently one of the members has been revealed. There's a co-founder that's been revealed named Hardy Fox, also known as Charles Bobucks. And he is one of the co-founders of the Residents. He claims to be the primary composer. Oh, he died. So right before he died, he revealed that he was one of the main Residents. That's crazy. I haven't listened to the Residents in a few years, so I didn't know that. A Residents tournament would be insane. We'd have to actually split it up into several different tournaments. That would still be pretty cool. It looks like they're still ongoing even. But we're listening to that today because we have another song from 1988 coming up. And that is a Butthole Surfers song, of course, as the title of this video implies. Hi, my name is Bean, and you're watching Battle of the Band. We're on day 93 of the Butthole Surfers tournament, and that is so close to 100, I could just scream. I can't believe how long we've been doing this already. I mean, it's only been a little over 100 days that we've been running the channel. But, that's crazy. I just found out my new Beatles video is blocked in Belarus and Russia. I've been getting blocked in Russia a lot lately. I'm sorry for any of my Russian fans that are watching. For some reason, the occasional song gets blocked in Russia. And if it was blocked worldwide, I'd do something about it, like reverse it and make it all weird. But if it's only going to be in one or two countries, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Those are videos you might need to figure out a VPN for. where were we? Oh yeah, so anyway, we're on day 93 of the Butthole Surfers tournament. And if you're not familiar with the Butthole Surfers tournament, basically what we did was we took every single Butthole Surfers track, we threw them into a single elimination style tournament, and then we make them face off, battle in head-to-head competition until we decide which one is the very best Butthole Surfers song ever written. We've just had 2 days worth of songs from Hairway to Steven, and since we're covering the first half of the album just in this 4 day span, we have another song from Hairway to Steven coming up. But first we'll be listening to The Lord is a Monkey. And The Lord is a Monkey is from the 1996 album Electric Larryland, their second to last album they've released, at least so far. So this is one of those songs that I know, I just can never remember it when I see the name. This one actually had an easy first round. It had a bye through to the second round, and it went up against Pittsburgh to Lebanon in order to get to the second round. I can't really remember Pittsburgh to Lebanon, so I'm not really sure why I would picked The Lord is a Monkey, other than obvious familiarity being a 90s Butthole Surfers fan, at least coming into the tournament. And that's going up against I Saw an X-Ray of a Girl Passing Gas from their 1988 album, Hairway to Steven. It is so hard to say that song title with a straight face, and I still didn't do it. That song had to go up against, it got a bye in the first round, and then it went up against Wichita Cathedral in the second round, which I remember that one was a pretty fun song, but obviously I thought An X-Ray of a Girl Passing Gas was a more fun song. So since we've listened to both of these, I guess we should just go ahead and get right on into it. First up, we have The Lord is a Monkey. We'll be right back. It's a fun song. Just a good, wholesome song about smuggling drugs in your ass, you know? I love the ending on that song. The outro is like about a solid minute almost of just like speeding up what they're doing and just kind of freaking out a little bit along the way. The bass is going nuts. I love how fast he's playing that bass. Also, the line or the bit after she's got a needle in her eye. Like the part where it, like everything kind of cuts out a little bit and it gets a little just really fuzzy and kind of muted. I really like that too. Funny lyrics. Definitely like Gibby rapping a little bit. Gibby's a weird guy. Like I posted the video 2 days ago, I think, that had Gibby's basketball like photo, like from when he was playing basketball. And I didn't know he played basketball firstly, but he's a tall, lanky guy. I could imagine he'd be playing some basketball. But I read this news article or something. It was an article in a magazine, basically, or maybe just it was a website. But it was talking about how Timothy Leary had used Gibby Haynes and Al Jorgensen from Ministry as acid test subjects for his experiments at some point, which is crazy. Like, it kind of explains how Gibby's so weird, though. Ministry's pretty weird, too. I haven't listened to as much Ministry. That's going to be a fun tournament when we do that one, too. We'll also have to get some revolting cocks in here at some point. Here is, I saw an x-ray of a girl passing gas. More needle lyrics.
Will Uncle Doc's nurse use a needle with ungodly charm? Whoa, 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 whoa. Walking down the hall, the dentist loomed through the door. Hey, 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 Dad.
All right. I don't know if any of you noticed, but I saw an x-ray of a girl passing gas has the same like vocal patterns as the chorus on Cough Syrup. I saw an x-ray of a girl passing gas. I can't walk, so I guess I'm gonna stay at home. It's like the same song almost, except like they made more of a song out of Cough Syrup. Something they were gonna try to sell on the radio anyway. I like the little freak out portion at the end of X-ray. The acoustic bits too. It's kind of short for something off off of Hairway to Steven too, which is kind of decent sometimes after the 12-minute song yesterday. But I think I'm going to give it to The Lord is a Monkey. That one just has, it's almost a coin flip, really. It's just that this one's one I'm more familiar with overall. And I do like the guitars in this one as well. And the bass, like the ending of this one, I liked a bit better because I like it when they just start speeding things up until it just completely freaks out and falls apart at the end. That's a good ending to most songs. I'm down with that. So I'm definitely going to give it to The Lord is a Monkey. We've got social media if you want to talk about it. You can check us out on Instagram. We've got Facebook and Twitter. Instagram actually has a polling system set up so you can actually vote on which one you'd like. And the next day, tomorrow, you'll see what won with the fan poll in the end. So your vote is important if you're a fan on Instagram. When your vote's important anyway for you, but it doesn't change my channel. I also link the songs down below so you can check those out if you'd like to after this, before this, during this, whatever you want. They're in the description. The tournament's also linked in the description, so you can check that out as well. We've got Cash App and Venmo, so I'll throw the handles down at the bottom of the screen for that, just so you know what those are as well. You can like this video, and I suggest you like this video. Subscribe to the channel. I suggest you subscribe to this channel. Should I just say to do everything and then suggest it afterward? Share this video with your friends and families, and comment down below with which song you would have picked out of these two, if you would have picked one of these songs out of these two. Some people have too hard a time picking, and that's totally cool. I picked one. We won't listen to the other one next round. Hope you all have a great night, fantastic afternoon, and a wonderful morning. There's a TikTok too. I forgot to mention that in the social media stuff. So make sure you check out that TikTok too, because we're doing pretty good there. Been like a lot of views, a lot of followers. Bye. I guess now that I said it, I gotta look that up. Like from 1978, Duckstab is a great album. We do have what is it? You can check,